Hey, it's May 24th, 2014. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. As we approach the Memorial Day weekend here in the U.S., violence has continued to erupt in Ukraine. All eyes are on Ukraine. They're going through an election. Two of their regions in the eastern part of the country aren't even really having full participation because of the violence. We have pro-Russian forces fighting the pro-Western forces and the government forces. There was an attack on the 22nd in which about 13 to 14 or maybe as many as 16 Ukrainian soldiers were killed, okay, by pro-Russian forces. The situation is completely out of hand. Russia is claiming that they're going to stay out of it. There's reports that the Russian forces are moving away from the border of eastern Ukraine. Obviously, Russia has pretty much taken over Crimea in the southern region of the country. And I don't know who's going to win this election. Ultimately, I think Russia is going to be in control. And I see that thing playing out all over the world. I see U.S. foreign policy and intervention in places like Syria and Libya, and even to some degree in Ukraine, is going to force countries that may not even like one another together to work against the United States. There was a $400 billion gas deal between Russia and China. Russia and China signed a huge $400 billion natural gas deal. Now, what this means is that even if the Western European countries try to boycott Russia because of their moves in Ukraine, Russia has opened up a new market in China. China's a expanding civilization with an increase in industrialization. They're relying on more industrial products, and they need more energy to fuel their more industrialized economy. What this means is that this is going to be great for China, more access to energy, and Russia is going to be able to sell more of its energy. So they're going to be able to operate without being too influenced by the United States. I think the United States foreign policy and its dying dollar is going to create a situation in which the U.S. economy, its consumer-based economy, is going to fall apart. And the U.S. is going to be desperate, and they're going to drag a bunch of European countries into a war with the more productive countries like Russia and China. And we're going to see an economic downturn, which will eventually, in my opinion, lead to a world war, unless things are changed. At this point, the United States is isolating itself, and it's just basically, it's going to get to a point where it's going to be wandering in the wilderness. And we're all going to have to deal with the consequences. So thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.